we're back, and it is episode 3 of the Road to Powerlifting America Junior Nats Prep, and it is week 4 of the volume block. The block before the final block, heading into the meet. Today we have bench. I'm feeling good, I'm feeling strong, I'm feeling powerful. We're waiting for Steve and Dion to get here, and we're gonna get after it.
Bro!
We're going faster than
you. You don't care about those.
Sean.
Days where you couldn't even bend 408.
That shit was embarrassing.
You have two healthy arms. Two working arms. Yes, you're right. There's a lot to be thankful for.
You're right.
Yeah,
you're right.
It's a flip with a perspective. Yeah. I'm big with perspective. Mm-hmm. If you look at it like today sucked, it's gonna suck. But if you think, wow, I'm blessed, I'm living life, I have a company, I'm healthy. There's people that are in the hospital.
Damn. All right, you're going to have to get there.
There's people working 9 to 5, not making ends meet, and you're in with a company.
That's why when you have
life, people adore you. There's a lot to be thankful.
Yeah, you're right. There's a lot to be thankful.
Yeah.
You're like, you don't be mad about nothing no more. I don't have to be.
I know, you're never mad at me.
I don't have to be.
Yeah.
There's nothing to be mad about.
Perspective.
You're right.
Literally,
yeah.
We Hispanic people are literally like, yo, did you see worker? Like, did you see Wee's company?
That's
it's
so funny.
Yo.
Hey man.
I was just talking to Joel about that and about yes, I'm talking to Joel and he turned on his shit.
Hey, you gotta keep grateful. There's a lot of work to do.
Right.
Be grateful. And they're right in.
Even the last rep on that one felt easier than the last rep on the other one. Yeah. I'm standing like more under myself.
Yeah, you have no leverage there.
I know, dude.
Dude, it's hard to fight for it on a set of 8, like.
I know. I got pulled out, yeah.
Yeah.
listening. Damn, I'm listening. She listening. Keep my hotel keys like gas sent you. You dig? That comes on my beat, got a vibrating on my beat. Born in Colorado, smoke California beef. The bitch so bad, call her TV because I really want to meet her. And I ain't kidding no one, but never want to see her. Hey, want to see her.
Hey.
All right, so that was the workout. We ended with 424. We're in volume. I think I had an unrealistic expectation to try to make it move faster than my last block's 424 before the 441. But it is what it is. 424 moved good. Like, I just had a different number coming into this session in my mind. So when I hit 192 or 424 and it moved good, I was like bummed out because I expected it to be a bit stronger. And then we had a top set of eight with 342 for eight. And I just wasn't strong enough to lock out the third rep. I think I needed to work harder to fight to keep my positioning throughout the set of eight. Because as you guys know, when you do sets of eight, it becomes harder and harder to maintain your form. So I just feel like I fell short in that aspect, but it is what it is. So we're gonna try to have a short memory, go home, eat, rest, recover. And we'll be back for week four squats tomorrow. Welcome to Tuesday. We're about to get into some week four squats. It's me and Dion right now. I don't know where Steve is, something happened to him. I don't know what happened, but we're about to get into it. Just us, sit back, enjoy the vibe, because I know that's what I'm gonna do.
Bro.
Dive on the mat, warm up, and then like have the top set be empty like I've been doing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay, that was 7-11 right there. That was our intended target for week four, and it moved exactly how it needed to. Couldn't be more happy with it, but the work's not finished because we got a big back down set now.
Hold up, take your time, no rush.
Oh, final countdown.
Each one is the same, good work.
After the first rep, I know. That was 601 for eight. I don't think have I done that? Yeah, that's a PR right there. PR set of eight. Let's keep going.
Dude, your timing's like impeccable.
I wouldn't even be doing it on purpose either. That's just how you know it's divine intervention. Okay. So to recap today's workout, 672 last warm up, 711 top set. Moves were pretty impeccable. 601 for 8 PR. Never done that before. 2 sets of 8 at 508. I can't even talk right now, but. Today was exactly how we needed it to go on the deadlifts.
Oh, fuck.
What up, y'all? So it is Thursday around 4 p.m. and we are around 3 hours out from heading to the gym right now for deadlifts. I woke up about 5 or 6 hours ago and I've just kind of been doing miscellaneous things that I have to for getting prepared for worker and then the stiff sleeve restock coming, some customer service things. And right now I'm drinking a coffee because I had my 1,000-calorie shake this morning, but I've just been really bloated these past couple days because I've been eating so much food. Like, obviously, I'm trying to bulk right now, and I don't know. I don't like the feeling of being bloated all the time. So essentially, I'm having this coffee right now because I'm trying to just clear out my system, and then I'm gonna have one more meal that I'm gonna show you guys in a bit, consisting of just ground beef, rice. I'm gonna make like a taco bowl style thing, and I'll probably eat all, if not the majority of it. That made no sense. The majority, if not all of it, prior to heading for that session. So I'll cook that with you guys. I had my 1,000-calorie shake this morning, but I'm probably gonna have another one tonight after deadlifts just because when I deadlift later in the day, it's harder for me to fit my food in because when I'm on schedule and I lift like earlier in the day, I pretty much have the same routine every single day in terms of I wake up, I have this meal, I go train, I come back, I cook or I put rice in the rice cooker and I start to cook my ground beef while I hop in the shower, come out, finish that meal, eat that, work, eat in a couple hours later after that, and then I'm usually like close to finishing my food for the day and I just like finish out whatever I need in terms of macros. So when I switch around my Thursdays and everything is kind of out of whack, I need to kind of front load my calories earlier on in the day because I know that I'm gonna be lifting later on in the day when I usually eat the majority of it. So I'm gonna have another shake probably after deadlifts when I get back. So for any of you guys that don't know the shake that I make, I'm gonna show you guys when I get back. But as of now, I'm just gonna continue to work a little bit more on my computer. I might eat, go outside and get some steps in and then eventually have that one meal and then go deadlift.
I'm sorry, but I forgot to record. This is the ground beef rice shredded cheese that I made up. This is a cup of cooked rice, 8 ounces of ground beef, 85-20, and then a quarter cup of shredded cheese. And just mixed up. This is the passion fruit tea 110 pre-workout. This is what I'm gonna be sipping on over to the gym right now. I like the tea flavors because they're just very, very tame and they don't taste like a McDonald's Sprite mixed with battery acid. As all 110 flavors, they all taste great. Pre-workout or gym fit. I'm a fucking clown. We got the worker hat, the worker distressed dad hat, obviously. Never leave the house without it. The worker 3/4 sleeve cropped tee because it's cropped a little bit. We're gonna bring this down actually half an inch right here because we don't want anyone's belly button showing. It's supposed to look like a cropped look, but not too cropped. We got the worker tank under distressed tank, embroidered logo, and then the worker 5-inch inseam performance shorts. We're ready.
Perfect because I was vlogging on the way over here and earlier, so the continuity is gonna be perfect.
Holy shit, dude. Thank you.
There's no better way to spend the week for deadlift driving down the highway as the sun is setting, listening to old Trippie Red and singing it at the top of your lungs. No better way. We're about to get straight into it though.
That is, this might be the biggest dog. Actually, this might take, this is the Saint Bernard, right? Look this guy me. Might take the cake from my favorite 21st Street Barbell dog.
Holy.
All right, it's lock in.
Trust me, I'll try.
My calves. I don't know how I feel to my calves right now, but I do.
Oh, you probably have hurt in your ankle.
I think I did, because I was like, ow! Dude, that shit hurt the lockout.
Ooh. I don't know how you're able to do that after doing what, 617 for eight?
So we did 617 for six last Saturday, and then we just did 601 for eight earlier this week.
Oh my god. Like, that makes zero sense to me. That makes zero sense.
Dude, that pull extracted a heavy toll, okay? I'm not gonna lie. Like Thanos.
That just shows if he's not fatigued, like anything he wants is his.
That's the goal.
Mama told me go and get it. I've been trying to get a ticket. Get it. Commas, commas, go some digits. Been thinking about it for a minute. Yes, sir. I'm not a lieutenant. Sitting blue on the pendant. Can you finish a sentence? Every day, money get plenty. I was like looking for a block of chalk to like have right next to me in case
I could have gave you liquid chalk at least.
Felt good. That was 650 for five. And did pretty alright. Dude, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. That 755 took it out of me. After that, we did 650 for five, smoked me even more. And now I'm doing sets of five with 540. We had the big top set, big back off set, and now we're just chilling out, but I just feel so pumped in my lower back right now. It just kills, but we're gonna do everything we can to be ready for Saturday, because Saturday is the last secondary day of the volume block going into the meet. So we got a number in mind for that day, but we're gonna listen to the body no matter what, so. We're gonna finish strong here, hit our accessories, and go home and handle what we need to outside of the gym.
Big man,
she might die. I was
fatigue, bro.
Breaking.
Fatigue right now is at an all-time high. I was like laying down earlier. You guys ever get that lower back pump? And like even laying down doesn't make it feel better? Lower back kills right now. I think we have some RDLs that we gotta do.
Big man.
I gotta check the sheet.
Big man.
We shredded the body
to its last atom today. The weightlifters are all here right now. I was chatting up the weightlifters before I got into the week four, but they were loading up because they couldn't fit any more 45s on the hip thrust right there. And I'm like, I like it. Me personally, like run out of space for the 45s, progressive overload that motherfucker, put on the reds. Why not? Like, I should start doing that on bicep curls because I know the French do it. They lift with all kilograms, like none of that shit. I think it's perfect. Life is my type of father, I kill for my son Enoch is the part two. When I inspire my children to make high values, in this present moment I saw that dude as witty. It's a great feeling when you feel yourself getting stronger on the accessories.
There's like a chocolate milk stain on the mirror. Holy shit.
It looks like blood, to be quite honest.
Dude.
It is blood, matter of fact. Somebody got their face smashed on that mirror here one day. But the mirror didn't break. There was only blood.
It was Steve who did it.
Steve did it, dude. He does everything. Hate him. Good workout overall, man. I'm really happy with how this week four has been going so far. Don't want to jinx anything, but I'm happy with how everything's been going. We just need to keep our foot on the gas. We're handling what we need to inside and outside the gym. Life stress is much lower than it used to be. So when your life stress is lower, naturally your training's gonna go better as well. Which is why you guys saw me say like four months ago, I was like, if you guys are ever in a situation that doesn't suit you, that it doesn't facilitate your growth, remove yourself from it. Because when you put yourself first and you do what you need to do, not what everyone else is doing, but what you need to do, you're gonna notice everything start trending up. I'm telling you. That was perfect. We're gonna wrap up today's day of filming right here with Doja Cat singing Streets to us in the background.
Hey.
Hey, sneak attack.
Sneak attack.
Dude, we have teleported to Saturday morning and it is the last workout of the second to last week four, going into the meme. This, today, we have a very elusive volume set that if we hit at the prescribed RPE, says a lot regarding where we're gonna be at meet day. I'm wiping my tears right now, cause I'm not gonna lie, I was listening to Frank Ocean on the way over here, and I'm not gonna lie to you guys, sometimes, like, no joke, I would start crying on the way to the gym. Cause I think about, like, I swear to God, like, I think about just the journey we've been on since around November, since the Great Reset, and I think about how far we've come to this point now. And, like, we just have to do ourselves the honor of just, like, continuing along that path, continuing to get stronger, continuing to push forward. Because if we were to come this far and stop or not do what we need to do, it would only be a dishonor to ourselves. So I was just thinking that and having a bit of like an existential moment on the way over here to the gym, but I'm ready to do what I have to do for this week four and then the final 5 weeks going into the meet. This is the most important meet of my life and I'm leaving no stone unturned. So let's get after it in there.
Yeah.
Fucking bar.
Holy shit.
What you want? 4-2? Straight to it?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Right, let's get it. Shit. That was 650 for 5 right there. Good set. Let's keep going.
Go. 5-4.
Go. Go. Five. So to recap, we did 650 for 5, 551 for a 3x5. Now we got pulse deadlifts. We'll see what we got.
It's been a rough day for us. But it's good. Tell baby
That's how I feel right now. I feel like I just got snapped away.
He was cooked.
I was just teleported into dust after that asteroid.
Then he brought it back. He brought it back, baby. And they won.
There's no comfortable position to stand in right now. Feels like somebody's grabbing my erectors and ripping them off the bone.
That sounds like some Jurassic Park shit.
That's how it feels, bro. Got a velociraptor killing my shit. All right, y'all, so that concludes the week before the last sprint into the meet. We concluded with an 857 kilo total this meet. Week consisting of a 711 squat, a 424 bench, and a 755 deadlift. All moved spectacularly. Today we finished with 683 pause deadlift and then 650 for six on the squat. So can't ask for much else, man. You just gotta keep moving forward. But if y'all tuned in and watched the whole video, I really appreciate y'all, man, because I say it every video, but I wouldn't be able to do what I do without you guys. And there's a lot more coming down the pipeline, and I'm just so excited to share it with you all. But without further ado, if you guys enjoyed the video, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Yeah.